She's been nicknamed the Make My Day Mom, but this is not a Hollywood movie. It was for real for one widowed teen mom. The 18-year-old says she did what she had to do to protect her infant son when two intruders broke into her home on New Year's Eve, and now she is being called a hero. NBC's Tan Truong has the story.
Home is where you're supposed to feel safe. So when 18-year-old Sarah McKinley heard danger, literally, knocking at her front door in rural Oklahoma, she grabbed her guns and called 911.
Yes, I've got two guns in my hand. Is it okay to shoot them if you come from the store?
Well, you have to do whatever you can do to protect yourself.
Recently widowed, Sarah had to protect not only herself, but also her three-month-old son.
Is he trying to get in the door?
He just keeps knocking.
With her shotgun loaded, Sarah waited to see if anyone would break in.
I waited for 21 minutes while he busted in my house. And when he did, I shot him, but I didn't have that choice.
The intruder was 24-year-old Justin Martin. Investigators say he was carrying a knife. Authorities also arrested and charged Dustin Stewart for the New Year's Eve attempted burglary. Just 2 days before that shooting, a teenager from a small town in North Carolina had to take similar deadly action. The 14-year-old boy used a shotgun to defend himself as a man broke into his family's home, as you'll hear in these 911 recordings.
This one had a gun now.
What kind of gun? A big gun? Small gun?
He had probably a handgun, and he came around the corner, pointed it at me. When he did, I fired two shots.
And just this week near San Francisco, a 90-year-old retired sheriff's deputy shot a burglar three times in his home. The suspect survived and faces charges of attempted murder and burglary. In each case, the people defending their homes face no charges. 21 states have laws allowing deadly force in those situations.
You have to make a choice, you or him, and I chose my son over him.
The second suspect in the Oklahoma case is now out on bail and has made no pleas or statements. Under Oklahoma's so-called Castle Doctrine, he, not Sarah, is now charged with murder because the death happened during the commission of a crime.
Things will get better.
Sarah says if he or anyone tries to threaten her and the baby, she'll be armed and ready. For today, Tan Truong, NBC News.